Well, the Frankenlab is getting a real tear down. It's being disassembled, seriously. And the reason it's being disassembled is because we need to add a new plate to it. What you doing, Marshall?
I'm making that plate for your mill.
That's gonna be the piece that holds the laser in place, huh?
That's gonna be it.
That's gonna be awesome. All right, so we've got the laser assembly put together here. And so now we're gonna try putting it on the machine. And we've got a couple of things that we've added. We've got a switch down here where, in theory at least, when this thing comes down, it'll contact, and then we'll back it off to get automatic focusing. The other thing that we've got is we've got a switch for the top plate, and that one goes in here like
no communication.
This, and that's going to be a dual purpose. When it's mounted in here like that, and this piece comes up, this will be out here. When this piece comes up, it'll contact it, and then that's going to be the homing switch. So I should, in theory, be able to set a home position, go down and find the surface, and then automatically set the focus and the limit of throw. So we'll see how that works. Woo-hoo. All right, so we're going to give this thing a try. First off, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell it to set to zero. We've got an automatic switch in there. So it should go down, touch the plate, come back a little bit, come in and touch it. Now it should be set. We'll tell the laser to fire at 0.05. We've got a beam. That looks good. All right, I'm going to turn that off. All right, now I'm going to tell it to fire at half power. Firing and off.
Woo! Smell that burn.
Hey, you can laugh at Riley. He's being safe. He's being safe. We've all got our little laser glasses on here. We're all good to go. We've got a new routine. And last one, we ran it at 100 millimeters per minute. Now we're going to do 1,000 and see if this thing even makes a mark. If so, man, that's going to be pretty wild. So let's fire it up. Oh, I forgot to, that was cool. I forgot to tell it to go back down to zero. So hang on a minute. G0A0. Let's bring it into the focal length. Now let's run it. It marked it at 1,000. It marked it at 1,000.
Yep,
that's cool.
So that's moving that thing at 1,000.
That would cut cardstock.
Oh yeah.
Well, go ahead and put that piece of cardstock on there, and we'll give it a shot. Okay, I modified the code so that this time it'll automatically drop it down, and we're going to see if it does anything to cardstock. So, let's see what we got. That marked it.
Yeah, cut it.
Oh, it cut it.
Wow. And marked the wood underneath.
Wow, awesome. So it cut that cardstock and marked it underneath. Let's fire it again, just because we can. 3, 2, 1. That's so cool. That is so cool. YouTube, I've been busy. I know I told you that I was going to do a couple of videos for Frankenlab. I was going to do one. I'm adding a new spindle feedback so I can get real-time display on the speed of the spindle. Still working on that. Circuit's a little bit glitchy. I've got that down in here. And I know I said I was going to do a little more details on the touch probe and the regular probe. Still working on that too. But I kind of got sidetracked. First of all, I want to thank AVE for the great t-shirt. He liked my Imperial March on the Big Mill, so he sent me this. And I really appreciate that. But we've got some cool stuff going on here. Added a new component to the Frankenlab. If you can see this right here, I got a little second part that can go up and down. And that's not the Z-axis. The Z-axis is back here. What this is a 15-watt laser. Yes, folks, a laser. And I've done some pretty interesting things with it. Every YouTube video that I've seen about these lasers, they have this little plastic gauge, they stick it in there, and then they raise this little bridge up and get the focus, and I'm like, it's a computer, people! So I put a switch in here and let it come down, figured out how far off the surface it was and how far it needed to go, wrote a routine, so now what I can do is I can take this thing and bring it down near the surface, and all I have to do to set the exact focal length on it is do that. It's going to come in and it's going to automatically set its own height. So all the testing is done. Let me bring you in here and show you around a little bit more. So right here I've got an LED hooked up to the laser, so see, I can turn it on and I can turn it off. So that was to let me simulate a laser firing, and when I type in the appropriate G code, I can have it fire as well. And so far all the testing is working out good. This is part of the spindle thing. As the spindle's spinning around, you know, it detects it. But like I say, when I get it to a certain thing like this, it should be either on or off, and I've got to diddle with it. I've got to change that around. But this is functional now, so yay for that. A little PSA here. Do not play with lasers unless you have the proper eyewear on. These things put out an immense amount of light, and it can just take one little poof, and you can be blind. Glasses, people. Glasses. And get a couple extra sets so when you get your friends over, they can watch too. Now I'm going to apologize in advance for the sound of the fan. I don't have a proper evacuation system on here, and it's going to be my kind of attempt to keep from setting off the fire alarms. So anyway, let's move this over just a hair. Kind of get it sort of centered up right there. We'll lock that in as the new home. And turn off the spot. And I've got the laser running at 1% power. So that's 1% power. And, okay, boys and girls, this is the first attempt at actually cutting something with a CNC program. Have not tried it. If you're going to do it, let's do it big, right? Going in 3, 2, 1, fire. First test, we did really good. That was 0.25 on the power scale there. So, yay! Alright, attempt number two. I'm going to turn the spot on. And you notice how it blurs out at in a wider setting like that. So let's go and bring this thing forward about there. And I'm going to command this thing to go down to its focal point. That should be a good location, and I'm going to do this run at 1/2 power, and we should see a difference in this run. So I'm going to set that as a new home position, going in 3, 2, 1. Let's see if we notice a difference on this one. Oh yeah, a lot more smoke. Probably set the smoke alarm off. There, huh? Nice. Let me turn this fan off. I think we're done with the smoke for now. Man, it worked. I'm really, really psyched about that. It's pretty cool. That's half power. And at the speed that I had this thing moving, it was probably 3 times faster than what I've seen most of the guys on YouTube doing. I was running this thing at 1,000 millimeters per minute. So yay, I could slow this thing down to 100 millimeters per minute, same power, and it would cut a lot deeper. Only problem is that wouldn't be able to handle the smoke, and my smoke detector's right there, so it would get a little noisy in here. But it's portable, so I can take it out on the porch and do some other testing, and there'll probably be future videos. The way I've got this thing designed, in theory, I can laser engrave something, then know what the offsets are, automatically have it come over and have the engraver come down and cut it out. I gotta tweak it, I got some more math to do and some more settings, but when I do, there'll be a video. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. Hey, and hit the subscribe button. For those of you wondering how I did this, I'm using Vectrix Aspire. And in Vectrix, you can make post-processors. So you see I've got one here for Frankenlab. What I did was I went in to an existing one and I made the required modifications to it so that it would work. So now I've got it, and I'm going to post that on the Linux CNC forum for anybody else that has a Vectrix Aspire so that they can do it themselves. Woohoo!